If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now. What up, homies? I am Rob and this is my channel, Math Stuff with Rob. So to all my lovely subscribers, welcome back. And to all the new ones, thank you for stopping by. Now you can join the family. Just click on that subscribe button right now. Do it, I insist. And I'll thank you in advance. All right, let's start. I hope you guys remember my previous video right here, where I showed you a very simple DIY project on how to make a traveler's journal. So in that one, I showed you how to make the cover, which was this beautiful leather cover, which had these notebooks inside. And I promised you guys that in the next video, I'm going to show you guys how to make the notebooks. So today we are going to make saddle stitched notebooks. It's a fairly easy process and I am going to take you guys through it. So get ready. It's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. All right, let's begin. So I hope you guys remember this journal that I made last time with these booklets inside. Like I said, they are called saddle stitch booklets. The stitching inside or the binding inside is called saddle stitch. I'm going to show you how it's done. I wanted to keep the size small so that it's easy to carry. So here I have some sheets. So the white ones are cartridge sheets. You can also use regular printing paper, but I wanted something thicker so that I can sketch on it. And that's why I've taken this. I've already cut this to size. And for the cover, you can use different colored paper, like thicker chart paper or craft paper, wrapping paper, whatever you want. So I have these nice light brown, dark brown, and a black. I had used black last time. I wanted to have like a nice leather and black kind of feel. Now you can see here that these notebooks are fairly small and very easy to make. It has a stitch in the middle, goes all around. And now I'm gonna show you how you can do that. So first, we will take the white sheets and we will fold them in half. Just align the corners. Now the size of this sheet is 6 by 11 inches because I wanted small, almost like a pocket size kind of a notebook so that it's easier to carry because this is a traveler's journal. So now we'll take this and we'll fold this in half. Okay, we are done. So I have about 5 sheets. So what we'll do is we will just put them together like that. So you have a nice booklet. Now for the cover, you can just pick any color and make the cover. I'm just going to use this bright one. And just like the cartridge sheet earlier, I'm going to fold this in half, have a nice clean crease line. Okay, there you go, we have the cover. Now we will place all the sheets inside. There you go, we are done. So now our pages for the booklet and the cover is ready. Now I'll show you how you can stitch them or sew them together to make a nice booklet. Okay, so first we need to align them. I'm going to use these clips to hold all the sheets together so that they don't move. So there you go. You can see that we have put 4 clips. Now what we're going to do is we are going to make some holes here right in the middle where the crease is so that we can easily pass the thread and the needle through it. To make the holes, I am going to use a nail and our trusty hammer. So first I'm going to make one right in the middle. I'll place a piece of sunboard under it because I don't want to damage my mat or the table. Okay, we are done with the holes. Now you can take some strong thread and a big needle. So now we'll take the thread and we'll pass it through the needle. Now once you have thread the needle, take a nice long piece and you can cut it. Now you have to keep in mind, don't make a knot on the end. So what we'll do is, first we will pass it through the middle hole, pull it out and leave a little bit inside like this. Make sure you hold on to this extra bit, because when you're pulling it and tightening it, it can slip through. Now move to the next hole and pass the needle from the outside and pull it like this. Now we'll go to the alternate one on top, just like that. Every time you pass it, you pull it and tighten it. Now we'll move it back to the same hole, just like that. And once again, we are back to the middle one. And now we'll move to the other direction. And you can see, because we made the holes using a nail, it's really easy to pass the needle through it. And now we'll do the same thing, just like that. There you go. You can see we have passed it through all the holes, like that. And once you're done, you'll be left with the needle and the thread on the outside. And now you can tie a knot. You'll pass the needle through one of the sides, make a small loop, and then pass the needle through it, and then pull it, and you get a nice clean knot. Now you'll take the needle and pass it through the middle hole again. And now you have to pull it so that the knot is nice and tight. And now with this bit that we had left earlier, you can tie another knot and lock this whole thing in place. There you go. Now you can just cut the extra bit. So you can see with this simple saddle stitch, now the sheets are attached to the cover. Here I made only 5 holes, but if you have like a bigger size paper, I advise you to make more holes, which gives it more strength. So the binding has to be stronger. I did it right in the middle. In the earlier one, I went right to the top. So there's no fixed rule. Okay, so the stitching is done. Now we'll remove the clips. And this is how you make a saddle stitch booklet. Pretty easy. Also, you can use wrapping paper for cover. And after you make one, you can fix it in your journal, so it becomes part of your traveler's journal, or you can just carry them around like this. Looks pretty neat. And looks pretty professional. So customize it, make it personal. And yeah, that's how you make a booklet. So there you go, that's how you make a saddle stitch booklet. I really hope you found this tutorial easy and helpful. If you're making it, guys, then please don't forget to click picture and share it with me, because I would really love to see what you did with your booklet. You know how to get in touch with me. I'm on Facebook, I'm on Snapchat, Instagram, Twitter, and right here in the YouTube world, making DIY projects just for you guys. That's it for this video. I will see you in my next video. And like I always say, do good and be good. Peace.